Hey artists, welcome to another video. Today is gonna be the 23rd painting in my 30 paintings in 30 days challenge. So I'm gonna be painting another lion today. So this is from one of my own reference photos that I took at my local zoo. And I love the way that he was just sort of like looking up. It looks so majestic. So much fun. But what I wanted to talk about today is how to go about choosing the right surface for your artwork. Now, surface meaning basically what you're painting on. Different surfaces are gonna go and give your artwork different feels. So for instance, cradled canvas. So this is typically canvas that has been stretched over a frame, and especially if you use one that's like a bit thicker, this can definitely elevate the piece, sort of giving it more of like a museum quality feel. And especially since the actual like texture of the canvas tends to be associated with kind of more of like the old world masters paintings, so the canvas texture itself definitely has a little bit of an elevated effect. Whereas framed paper pieces can give your artwork a totally different vibe. And I'm not saying that one is better than the other by any means whatsoever. It's just something that you can definitely be aware of. So you have to consider the texture of your surface too, and how it's going to have a relationship with your art style, kind of the level of detail you want to achieve, and all sorts of different things. So canvas texture, for instance, is beautiful, but the fact that it does have that pretty defined texture of its own, in my experience, it can actually make it trickier to achieve tight detail thanks to that texture, because you're gonna be, well, I feel like I'm gonna say texture a million times, but it's true. You're gonna be fighting against that canvas texture. And especially when you consider that there's gonna be little divots in between the different threads, you're gonna be fighting against that. So if you are looking for a hyper-realistic portrait of sorts, it might be a little tricky to achieve with canvas because of that texture. Now, you could definitely go out of your way to prime that canvas a bit more so that it kind of levels out some of the texture, but it's just something to be aware of. So in opposition here, I often work with wooden panels, and typically what you do is you sand them, you add your primer to them, and you keep doing that. You're sanding in between, and it makes a really, really smooth surface. And what I love about this is that you can pack in a lot more detail because you are working with such a smooth surface. You're not fighting with that texture. So this is another thing to consider. Maybe you really like to get, you know, tons and tons of tight detail into your artwork, but maybe you've been struggling because you've been sticking with canvas, and you know, the texture of the canvas can actually make it trickier for you to achieve all that detail. So for this particular challenge, I wanted to push myself as far as texture goes, color, surrealism, and frankly, chaos. So canvas was the perfect option for me. Here I am using loose canvas sheets that I'm cutting down to size, which is why I have to tape them to my board here, because otherwise they're just gonna be flapping around. So one of the things is that my loose brush strokes, so you can kind of see in like the background there, or even on the very left side of the painting here, those loose brush strokes were actually accentuated by that canvas texture. And this really helped me to play up that painterly effect that I was going for. So again, I think canvas here was a perfect choice for me for what I wanted to achieve. So give yourself an opportunity to explore different surfaces. You definitely aren't limited to canvas, wood, or paper even. I've painted on everything from feathers to saw blades. So experiment and have fun. Alrighty friends, that brings us to the end of this video, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks so much for watching!